Hello and welcome to Newsclick. I'm Sumedha. In this episode of the Daily Roundup, we give you a heads up on some of the most important stories that we've been reporting about at Newsclick. आज हम मुख्य रूप से चर्चा करने वाले हैं कश्मीर पर. हम देख रहे हैं कि पिंगलन इलाके में, जो कि साउथ कश्मीर में है, उसमें मिलिटेंट्स और पुलिस फोर्सेस के बीच में एक गन फाइट काफी समय से चल रहा है. This comes in the background of the gruesome Pulwama attack, which killed at least 40 CRPF personnel. These operations are being jointly carried out by the team of the Army, CRPF and SOG from Pulwama. As per reports, two militants have been killed in the recent encounter, whereas four army men, including a major and a civilian, have been killed at the encounter site. Among the dead are Major D.S. Dhodial, Head Constable Savaram, Sipoy Ajay Kumar and Sipoy Hari Singh. The clashes have been going on for at least the last 12 hours and are still continuing. ये सब developments होने के बाद एक नजर डालते हैं कि केंद्र सरकार ने आखिर किया क्या है. The Pakistan High Commissioner to India has been called back to Islamabad for consultations amid the tensions with neighboring countries over the Pulwama terror attack. Another development that has happened is the fact that US has asked Pakistan to freeze the funds without any delay. A state government spokesperson has also gone on to state that Pakistan outlawed Jaish-e-Mohammed in 2002. However, as we can see, that the group is still operating in Pakistan. India has also revoked the most favored nation status which was given to Pakistan. The Jammu and Kashmir state government has also gone on to withdraw the security of five separatist leaders, which includes Hurriyat Conference chief Mirwais Umar Farooq. And at the same time, US has also gone on to state that they fully support actions which are oriented towards preventing them from conducting future terrorist attacks. Meanwhile, at a time when the whole country is mourning the heart-wrenching death of 40 CRPF personnel, the right-wing groups have taken this opportunity to spread their propaganda of hatred by targeting Kashmiris across the country. There have been several reported incidents coming out from different parts of India where Kashmiris have been targeted, beaten up, and they've faced death threats and rape threats. The worst kind of sufferers of this vicious campaign are the students. They've been forced to flee from their hostels following such threats. Kashmiri students are being forced to chant slogans of Bharat Mata Ki Jai. Not just that, the right wing has also dedicated a separate section on Twitter using different hashtags to create a hostile situation for the Kashmiris who are living in India. On one hand, while the right wing groups are not leaving any opportunity to make the mockery of the death of the CRPF personnel through their vicious campaign, quite a few people have come out in the support of vulnerable Kashmiri students. The centre too has issued an advisory to all states and union territories to assure the safety and the security of Kashmiris across the country. We urge our viewers to not fall through the trap of fake news and other kind of propaganda materials on WhatsApp or Facebook. It is important for India as a country to stand united in the face of terrorism. In our international segment, we're taking a look at the UK student youth mobilization on climate change, which happened last week in around 60 towns and cities. The largest mobilization took place in London, in the areas of Manchester, Brighton, Bristol, Leeds, Cardiff and Oxford. Thousands of students and youth gathered at the Parliament Square in London and demanded immediate and effective policies and action to tackle climate change. The UK Student Climate Network have demanded that the government declare a state of climate emergency and communication in the severity of the ecological crisis that is facing the general public. Additionally, campaigners want the curriculum reformed to address climate change as an educational priority, alongside a demand to include youth voices in policy making. That's all that we have for you today on this episode of the Daily Roundup. To follow our coverage on Kashmir and many other stories, please log on to our website www.newsclick.in, subscribe to our channel on YouTube and follow us on Facebook. Thank you for watching.